It is birthday time for everybody's favourite soap, The Bold and the Beautiful. It's turning 35 and boy, has a lot happened in that time. It was March 1987 and we were about to fall in love with a brand new soap and some brand new stars, including Catherine Kelly Lang. That was Brooke's very first appearance, and she's been through a lot of adventures since then.
Will you take this man to be your husband?
I will.
There have been more than 8,700 episodes, 393,000 pages of dialogue memorised, 100 weddings, most of them Brooke's, 23 babies born, and 1,793 cans of hairspray and 415 lipsticks used to make the cast bold and beautiful. Well, there are some huge celebrations planned for the big anniversary, and joining us now to tell us all about them are original cast member Catherine Kelly Lang, plus a couple of very handsome blasts from the past, Windsor Harmon, who played Thorn Forrester, and Jack Wagner, who played Nick Marone. It is great to see you all.
It's good to see you.
Great to see you.
Now, Catherine, I'll start with you. Tell me why these gorgeous blokes are coming back to the show.
Well, for the 35th anniversary show, we're doing a standalone show, so I can't really tell you everything because it's going to be a surprise, but Brooke gets to have a show with five of her very important loves that she's had throughout her life. So it's Windsor Harmon, who played Thorn, it's Jack, who played Nick, and Torsten, who plays Ridge, John McCook, who plays Eric. Who am I missing somebody? Oh,
yes.
Don Diamond. So all those men she gets to have a show with, and you'll see how it all pans out.
That sounds brilliant. Windsor, was it fun to be back? And exactly how many men has Brooke married since she and Thorn were together?
Five, six, possibly. I really have no clue. It was great to be back. It's always great. Kelly, without a doubt, has been probably my favorite co-star of all time and since I've started acting. And I love working with her. I loved the set, loved seeing Jack and all the other, you know, people there. So it was fun. We had a really good time, and I think you guys are really going to love the show.
Look at that hairdo on you. I'm just trying to match your hair my whole life. That's it. Just trying to have your hair.
Jack, you had some special moments too. What about those dramatic storylines with Brooke when you were held captive with Brooke and Ridge on their honeymoon by bad guys working for Sheila, demanding the gold that belonged to Massimo, who's actually your father and Ridge's father? Did I get that right?
Yeah, because I think about that every day, you know? All I know about that storyline is I had to do a lot of shows shirtless, so I was in the gym all the time, okay? And but that was one of those very dramatic and...
There it is.
Oh, my gosh.
There it is.
Look at that. We're so young, Kelly.
Oh, my gosh.
Great to play storylines like that that have a few villains involved, and there's some real suspense, and suck it in. There you go. Suck that stomach in. That's the key, right?
That's it.
If you do a shower scene, always hike that towel above your handles. That's all I know.
Do you know, that was my very first set visit to The Bold and the Beautiful was the day you shot that scene. And I thought that was just a normal day at work for all of you guys. It was terrific for me anyway. Catherine, you've been with the show since day one and it's just been renewed for another 2 years. Is it as much fun now?
It is. Thankfully, I love my job, and I don't even like calling it a job because it's so exciting for me to read the scripts and to go to work and to do what I really enjoy doing every single day. I have to say, I'm so lucky and I'm so grateful, and I've worked with so many wonderful people through the years and have had so many great stories through the years. 35 years, it's really actually hard to name everything and everything I've done through those years and people I've worked with, but it's really been a pleasure, and everybody puts in hard work. You know, it's from the cast, the crew, the producers, the writers, the hair, the makeup, every single person puts in all that work to make the show what it is. So kudos to everybody.
And Windsor, you guys are family. When you join Bold, mm-hmm. you're Bold forever, kind of, aren't you? Mm-hmm.
It is very true. You know, I'm working on a lot of productions, and Jack the same way. There's a different feeling there, and I think that's probably what has attributed to the humongous success to this show is the fact of the cast itself, and it starts from above with Brad as well coming down, and we don't just work together; we actually see each other on weekends. I mean, Kelly and I. Go biking, cycling. So it's a big family. It really is.
And Jack, we loved you on Bold. We also loved you on Melrose Place. And now we can love you in When Calls the Heart. What's that one like?
Oh, thank you for those kind words of yours. It's fantastic. We shoot this series up in Vancouver, and season 9 actually just premiered last night. So really grateful to be working in Hope Valley, we call it, but it's a period piece at the turn of the century in a pioneer town. But to come back to the Bold and the Beautiful, like Windsor just said and Kelly said, it's really a family feel. I hadn't seen anybody for, 10 years or so. It was so great to come back for this one-off episode, which is pretty much a tribute to Brooke, which should happen. Yeah. She deserves it.
You know, it's funny, too, as I remember when Jack first started the show, I was having a special birthday party. And I remember I told you, I said, hey, I'm having a birthday party. I want you to come. He had been on the show for a couple of days, and he looked at me like, really? I said, yeah, come, man.
All right.
I don't know you that well, but come.
I love that.
I'll never forget that when you showed up. This is back in my life.
How are you?
It was brilliant.
Okay. I'll show up.
It was brilliant.
Okay, you ready, folks? Renee would like to know, Catherine, what's your favorite storyline of all time?
Oh, gosh, there's been so many, I can't even name them all. But I'd have to say what's coming to mind is some storylines between me and Thorne and me and Nick, Jack and Windsor. About that time when I had to hide under the bed when Macy came in the room, right? Remember that,
yeah, that's
Windsor?
Right.
And then that's right. Jack, our characters, we had to sail away on the Shady Marlin to the deserted island, and you would sing me songs by the firelight. And that was so romantic.
Yes. I remember.
We've had so many.
That's great.
I love that one. Okay, the next question's from Luke. And boys, I might get you to take this one. What was Betty White like on set?
Go ahead, Windsor.
She's a constant professional. She was unbelievable, and she has a sense of humor, and it just, I can't say what she said on TV, but hearing Betty White say certain words is classic beyond, I mean,
She was very, very old school, old Hollywood. Yeah. I worked with Betty White quite a bit on Hot in Cleveland. I did a few episodes there, and to see her work in the comedy world in a sitcom was really unbelievable. She just has an incredible timing. And just a whole overall kind of sensibility about her that speaks to just such old Hollywood.
She never took herself seriously either.
Right.
And I mean, they had a big star up on the dressing room for her, and she just took it down. I remember her going, "Get that off of there." And she was one of a kind. I mean, she really was.
Beautiful memory there. Paul asks, "Do you ever think there will be a long-term marriage that lasts longer than a year?"
For who?
Maybe you, Catherine.
Real life or on soap?
Oh, on the soap.
Is that my question?
Yes.
Or you mean in general?
I think yours. I think it needs to be yours.
Okay, well, first of all, since I have been on the show for 35 years, really, Brooke hasn't had that many relationships or marriages when you think about it. So when that's what soap opera's made of, right, is romance. So... I don't know. You'd have to ask Brad that question and get some inside scoop from the writers.
We are seeing just a few of the marriages here now. since Ridge is stepping away, this comes from Julie, from Brooke. Could Nick or Thorne come back to rekindle their romance, boys?
You never say never.
Yeah, I mean, did she rate who was the best kisser between us? Did she mention
that? She said it was between us, is what she said.
Us, right? Yeah. To Kelly, I love you most. Yeah. Do you love her more?
I love her more.
I think I love her more. Yeah. Love her more.
Let's just say you both have luscious lips.
And there you have answered Harper's question, which was who has been the best kisser. So the verdict?
Oh, gosh, I can't give up that information. That's just too private. Everybody has something different to offer. But for this episode, I'll have to say it was Thorne and Nick.
What a champion. She's a champion.
She is.
I know.
She is.
I just think that's brilliant. Well, the special edition of The Bold and the Beautiful airs in Australia on April 5th. It has been so wonderful to catch up with you both. Happy anniversary. It is such a milestone achievement. Congratulations and thanks for stopping by.
Thanks. And congrats, Kelly.
Thank you.
Congrats, yeah.
Lovely being here.
Congrats, Kelly.
Thank you. Thanks.